Then expectation had hit a log of disappointment. They had hoped that found what they were looking for. But at the blink of an eye, it seemed. I will first say, it seems as if they have lost everything. It seems as if all hope was gone. It seems as if their future was no longer bright. It seems as if there was no anything good in
it.
So the Bible says they made a decision to leave this city of Jerusalem. Because something had happened in Jerusalem. There was trouble in Jerusalem. And the people had anything to do with this Jerusalem. So they were turning back home to a place called Emmaus. 7 miles from Jerusalem. 10 to 12 kilometers from Jerusalem. So as they were journeying home, They had no business with the stranger. They continued with their problems, debating among themselves, expressing their frustrations, expressing their anger.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And then the stranger intervened. What are you talking about? Why are you sad? They asked him, are you the only stranger in Jerusalem? You don't know what has happened? It is everywhere. They don't need, they're not pointing asking us. So the stranger asked, what happened?
What
and the Bible says,
look at the 4:19.
And he said to them, what things? So they said to him, the things concerning Jesus of Nazareth. Even Peter, who was supposed to be the rock of the church of the Bible,
had
rejected the master more than 3 times. Even after being forewarned and being prophesied to, you told them that he believed he could stand. They were afraid of
death.
They were afraid of prison. They were afraid of persecution. They were running away. Disciples of Jesus Christ that even lost their passion that they had for this man. They even lost the liberation that they had for this man. Because when they what things have happened? Concerning this other man, they called their master another man. The
one
that they put their strength against
Matthew 16,
son of God can be arrested and die.
In the hands of man.
So they called him. Jesus of Nazareth.
Yes,
he was of Nazareth. Just a prophet. We know he was mighty
indeed.
Before God and
men.
But he was crucified by
men.
He is now dead.
21.
But we were hoping. Because he was going to redeem Israel. In
peace,
they had lost hope. When Jesus called him, let me go and bury my father first. And I will come and follow you. Jesus told him,
yes,
lay the dead, bury the dead. But you follow me. Peter once asked this, Jesus,
what shall
we profit? After leaving everything, and following you, what is there for us? Hallelujah. So even these people, they had hoped. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you following?
Yes.
So on 21, indeed, besides all this, today the third day since these things happened. So it means maybe they waited for first day.
Second day
they waited
for happened.
We are waiting for something to happen. Maybe that something will happen to us. Verse 22. The Bible says, yes, and certain women of our company who are like the top player astonished us. When they did not find his body, they came saying that they also had a vision of the angel who said he was alive. And certain of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it just as the woman had said, but him they did not see. These people had lost faith. This is a clear demonstration that their faith failed. Because they are saying that after 3 days, the women went to see where was buried. So they were still doubting.
Verse 25.
All foolish ones, and so hard to believe in all the things the prophets have spoken.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So the Bible says a fool is a person who believes that God does not exist. So Jesus is calling the disciples foolish ones. Because they fail to realize. Amen. They fail to realize That with God all things are possible. That whatever Jesus said, it was true indeed. He told them before he died that he will suffer for 3 days. After 3 days, he will rise again.
But this did not believe.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And then he started explaining to them concerning himself. From Prophet Moses
to
the present, they failed to capture the a stranger in Jerusalem. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They didn't take time to ask, "Who are you, sir? Where are these things coming from? Are you one of us? Where are you getting this
things?
Because their hearts were sad.
When
the Bible says that their eyes were
strained,
they were walking with Jesus, conversating with him,
yet they did not know
him.
Because trouble had overtaken
him.
Fear in them was ruling more than faith. Because of fear, they were operating in fear. Their eyes of faith were blinded. They failed to recognize this. They called him a stranger. What an insult. What an insult. They called him a stranger. Yet without knowing that they were talking about him.
Look at the love of God.
Amen.
Amen.
He was with them all the way.
Amen.
Amen. Explaining to them. He was with him in that lion's den. Commanding his angel to close the mouth of those lions. That they should not destroy him. If you are truly a child of God, no situation can destroy
you.
If you have doubted this God, today is another opportunity. By his stripes today, you were healed. By his stripes today, you will be delivered in the name of Jesus. By his stripes today, you will be frightened in the name of Jesus. By his stripes today, you will be blessed in the name of Jesus. It doesn't matter how long you have suffered. You encounter this Jesus Christ through this Holy Communion. We are not taking this Holy Communion traditionally, but by revelation, knowing that the bread that we are taking, it is not the bread, it is the body of Jesus Christ. And the cup that we take, it is The blood of Jesus. That blood of Jesus Christ will begin to speak better things for you. More than the blood of your ancestors. Some of you are facing rejection of your life. You are facing affliction in life. Because of your bloodline. But there is another blood that speaks better for you. And the blood of our forefathers. And the blood of our foremothers. That is the blood of Jesus Christ. Today, I can confidently say, when this blood enters your system, anything that is not from God will be flying out in the name of Jesus. When this blood enters your body, anything that was blinded by Satan, it will be uprooted in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Begin to thank God wherever you are. Begin to thank you for
who he is.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to say, Lord, may I see you today. May I see you today. May I encounter you today. Let my life change today. Let me be divine today. Let me be healed today. Let me be delivered today. In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 And we see you, Lord Jesus, for the God today. In the mighty name of Jesus. And the darkness, Lord, let it be flushed out today. In the mighty name of Jesus. And the sickness, Lord, let it be destroyed today. In the name of Jesus, for the God. Because we are taking your blood today. We are taking your body today. In the mighty name of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, and the fire of the Holy Ghost.
Oh, Jesus, Lord, give us all faith.